I'd say he was 5'9" and probably 175 pounds.
He was a man of few words. You know, he was an infidel. He didn't go to church.
As children, we were afraid of him.
This farmer claimed that Charles Lindbergh was his daddy.
Nobody knew anything about him, very little about him.
He's a mystery, and he's forever going to be a mystery.
It was a great thrill to go to this farmer's studio and have your picture made.
Most of his subjects were people who came in from the country and got their picture made for a quarter.
Whoever came in got his picture taken, whether it was the mayor of the town or the paper boy or anybody in between.
I've heard some of the people say that when they had their pictures made, they were scared. That's the reason why they're just sitting there just so.
They're worried they're in front of this guy who's probably barking at them and not very nice, and they don't quite know what to do.
His portraits are gripping. There's pictures of a lost America.
I was immediately taken with them. They just seemed so powerful and so immediate.
I felt like it was something that should be saved and preserved.
The show and the book got reviewed, and it was like instant recognition of how wonderful the work was.
They're not even pictures anymore, they're money. They changed from pictures of my grandmother to money.
I thought $1,000 a picture was absolutely ridiculous for them to pay me for those 5 pictures, but I took it.
This is the store that I purchased with the sale of the Disc Farmer photos. If it hadn't have been for the Disc Farmer project, I would have never been able to start my own business.
What Disc Farmer has brought to Heber Springs has been a culture of the past that was lost. It could have been lost if these pictures weren't brought forward.
Disc Farmer is part of us. There's no question about that. Disc Farmer has become part of the community.